I remember the doctor came in there with like this 9-inch needle and was like, I'm gonna put this in the back of your knee. And I was like, bro.
If you want to have your own animated created avatar story time video, join us on Patreon, or the link will be in the description below with my email address.
How did I lose my leg? And I'm always getting asked,
how did you lose your leg?
What happened, dude?
Yo, why'd they cut your leg off?
Anyways, let's get into the story. I started getting pains in my right leg. Now, I didn't tell anyone about the pain. I don't know if anyone can relate, but being a chubby kid, oftentimes people look at you and they're like, wow, this kid is lazy. The pain was kind of on and off. It would hurt really bad, and then it would stop for a bit. I fought through the pain, and when I went home later that day, I told my mom that my leg had been bothering me. She instantly called my doctor and got an appointment scheduled for a few days later. When I was finally able to get to the doctor, they ran some tests and found out that I had blood clots. They ended up putting me on blood thinners, and I was taking 2 shots a day for several months. And dear God, those were painful. A few months after they diagnosed me with blood clots, I started noticing a swelling behind my right knee, so I went in to see what was going on. They did an ultrasound, and they found a mass, otherwise known as a tumor. They ended up sending me to a different hospital so I can go get a biopsy done. I remember the doctor came in there with like this 9-inch needle and was like, I'm gonna put this in the back of your knee. And I was like, bro. So she puts the needle in, starts wiggling it around, and I'm trying my best to hold back these tears. She takes it out, and I kid you not, she goes,
hey, do you mind if I put this back in?
Like, yeah, I mind. What? So she puts it back in and does the same thing. It hurts. You know, I'm still trying not to cry, but it is what it is. Not too long after that, I went back to the hospital to get my results. Me and my mom were sitting in the office waiting, and she came in and was like, you know, I'm sorry, I have bad news. The tumor was cancerous, and so they diagnosed me with osteosarcoma. Now, you're probably thinking that I like cried or that I was extremely upset about this, but in all reality, I was fine. But my mom, on the other hand, bursted out into tears, and I had to kind of comfort her and let her know that everything was gonna be all right. My surgeon told me that she wanted to remove the tumor as soon as possible, so she scheduled a surgery for a few weeks later. She made sure to let me know that there was a chance the tumor could come back. But I wasn't really worried about it. I was kind of like, yeah, it could come back, but it won't because I'm just a different breed. So anyways, I end up having the surgery, and it did not go as planned. Eventually, the tumor was able to be removed, but the surgery lasted like 20 plus hours. Basically, what happened was my nerves and arteries wrapped around the tumor, and my surgeon was completely unprepared for this. So she had to call a completely different surgeon in to help assist with the surgery. So apparently during this time, my mom was absolutely freaking out. But I mean, can you blame her? 20 plus hours of surgery, gotta be kind of scary for a mother. Anyways, I end up waking up, and this was probably one of the scariest experiences of my life. I woke up and I had a breathing tube in. For anybody that doesn't know what a breathing tube is, basically it's a long tube that goes down your throat into your lung to help you breathe whenever you're having a surgery. Every surgery I had previous to this, they had taken it out before I woke up. So I woke up and not only did I have this machine trying to breathe for me, but I also had a lot of stuff taped to my face, and I'm kind of claustrophobic, so I was freaking out. The breathing tube was in for so long that it ended up scarring the very tip of my tongue, so now I don't have taste buds there. After the surgery, I ended up being in the hospital for maybe like 5 days or so. But when I got home and I started to recover, I realized that from my knee down, I had like a very numb sensation. I could still feel my leg, but it just didn't feel the same. This was just simply due to the fact that they had to mess around with my nerves since they were wrapped around the tumor. So along with that, my right foot also would not flatten. So I ended up having to walk in like a kind of weird way. It was like a constant limp. A few months after I recovered, I noticed that the swelling had started to come back. So I instantly went to the hospital to get it checked out. They found that the tumor had indeed grew back. At this point, my surgeon didn't want to complete another surgery because she felt like it was too soon and she didn't want to go over scarred tissue. She said the best thing for me to do would be to complete chemotherapy. Hearing that I was going to have to do chemotherapy was something that really got to me. I thought I was going to lose my hair, and I knew that if I lost my hair, people would know that I had cancer, and I didn't want people to feel bad for me. Like, sure, people knew something was wrong with me, you know, some people knew I had cancer, but I just didn't want everyone to know. So I started chemotherapy treatments, and I had chemotherapy every Monday for 8 months. The first week of chemotherapy was easily the worst week of my entire life. I was in so much pain, easily the worst pain I've ever been in. I wasn't able to eat for like 4 days and I was just absolutely miserable. However, fortunately enough, I never lost my hair. After about 8 months of chemotherapy, I made the decision to quit my treatments. Chemotherapy kept my tumor from growing, but it didn't shrink it at all. I felt like the best option was to have another surgery, and so I did. Sadly, the surgery was completely unsuccessful and my surgeon was unable to remove the tumor. At this point, she gave me two options, radiation or amputation. I chose radiation because I wanted to give my leg one last shot. I ended up doing radiation for 7 weeks. It wasn't that bad compared to chemotherapy, but it wasn't the best. And unfortunately enough, radiation was also unsuccessful. So I was left with one option, amputation. And that's the story on how I lost my leg. At the end of the day, everything happens for a reason, and you've got to keep your head up and make the best of every situation. Thank you guys for watching.
Shout out to One Leg Wonder. This story time was very, very inspirational. I had to create this to animation. The link to his original video will be in the description below. If you guys can share this video, hit the subscribe button. This took a long time to make, just like these future videos. If you want to support the channel even further, I do accept donations. That's in the description below. And I'll see you guys in the next one.